him up. We come to tell the world he's worthy. We come to tell the world that he is God. And besides him, there is no God. There's nobody greater. There's nobody stronger. There's nobody mightier. He's our king. And not just king, but he's king over every king. Everybody that think they want to be king, our king is greater.
Yes, he is.
You have to declare that, not just on Sunday, but Monday through Saturday. You got to declare that he reigns. He reigns. When we're together, you got to declare. When you're by yourself, you got to declare that he reigns. Over the heavens, over the earth, and everything underneath the earth. Amen. He reigns. Amen. So we're going to do proxy prayer. We're going to welcome our visitor. Returning member.
Yeah.
It's been about 10 years.
Yes,
ma'am. Good to see you.
Good to see you.
Be blessed.
Amen.
Amen. You ain't gonna see this.
Hey,
but I seen your picture online yesterday. I said, Ruth. Where's Ruth?
Yes.
There's Ruth. And we decree and declare that your life shall never be the same. Never be the same. Hallelujah. We walk by faith and not by sight. Because what we see can deceive us. What we see can stagnate us and bind us and keep us from moving. But we're able, according to the words of God, we're able to run through troops and leap over walls because we have the King of Glory on our side. He's with us. And as Joshua said, he said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll be with you. Wherever the sole of your feet shall tread, it's yours. And nobody, your enemies, won't be able to stand before you. You got to feed that to your spirit. They can't overtake you. But you got to believe that. Amen. We're going to stand in proxy prayer for the sick and the bereaved. And our granddaughter, Denise Bell, her daughter was jumped by 7 people and was shot at. So we're family. Her granddaughter is our granddaughter. Amen. And the devil is a liar. Amen. He want to divide and conquer, but we are one. And the Bible says if we be of one mind, there's nothing impossible for us. There's nothing we can do. Hallelujah. When they was building the tower by Babel, they was divided against God. But we're with God and we're for God. So he's with us and there's nothing impossible that we can't do. Amen. We're the head and not the tail. We're above only and not beneath. We're blessed going out and coming in. Amen. Whatever we put our hands to prosper. Amen. You have to decree and declare that. We are one. Amen. So we stand and we cover our baby, cover our grandbaby. We cover her with peace. Amen. We cover her with the armor of God, which is the word of God, that she will be safe and protected. We thank you, Lord, that the enemy wasn't able to take her life. Amen. We pray for our children. Amen. May God keep our children safe, and they're going out and they're coming in and they're lying down and they're rising up. Lord, quicken them according to your word. Oh God, let your word be their armor. Let your word be their shield and buckler. Oh God, we praise you and thank you, Lord God, that we take authority over tormenting spirits. We take authority over harassing spirits. spirit and rioting spirit, oh God. Every thieving, murdering, destructive spirit, we take authority over you and now in the name of Jesus. And we cancel your assignment against our children in the name of Jesus. We cancel your assignment against the people of God in the name of Jesus. We decree and declare that the Lord is our shield. The Lord is our mother. He that dwelleth in the secret place shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. And I will say, and you have to say, the Lord is my refuge, my God, in him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver us from the snares of the fowler. And under his wings shall we trust. His truth shall be our shield and buckler. Oh God, we thank you that you are Jehovah Rapha, that you are our healer, that you were wounded for our transgression, that you were bruised for our iniquity. The chastisement or punishment necessary for us to have peace was upon you, and by your stripe, by the wound that you bore, oh God, you took those lashes for every sin, oh God, every lie, oh God, you took the whooping that we should have taken, oh God, and because you taken it, oh God, it's not ours no more. We have healing. By your stripes, we are healed. We decree and declare healing for those that are sick and shed. We send the word, oh God. You said if you send the word, it will heal, oh God. So we send the word, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, that you quicken them according to your word, oh God. That they are healed, Lord God. Cause them to rise up, oh God. We take authority over the spirit of infirmity. We take authority over the spirit of sickness and disease. For you have borne our sickness and carried our sorrows, oh God. You bared our sickness and our sin in your own body on the cross. And you broke the power of it. Lord God, we declare over our loved ones that the power of sickness and disease is broken, Lord God. And if there be any sin, Lord God, we ask that you forgive, oh God. Wash them with your incorruptible blood, Lord God. We thank you, Lord God. Your word declared to everything there is a season. To everything there is a season. To everything there is a season, Lord God. So we lift those up who have lost loved ones, who's grieving, oh God, because their loved ones have gone on, Lord God. But you said to everything there's a season, a time to be born and a time to die. Lord, we didn't come here to be here forever, oh God. Lord, so we pray for those who are grieving, Lord God, that you'll usher them through the grieving process, Lord God, that they won't camp out there, because you say grief is bonding, oh God, that they won't camp out in the place of grief, oh God. But Lord, if it's something they didn't do, let them forgive themselves. If there's something they wish they hadn't done, Lord God, let them forgive themselves, oh God. Lord God, we thank you, Lord. You've already forgiven us, Lord. Let them accept your forgiveness, oh God, and forgive themselves. And let them move on, Lord God. Let not the enemy bound them and keep them stagnant from doing the work of the Lord. We praise you and thank you, Lord God. For those who wanted to be here, oh God, Lord God, that didn't have transportation, whatever the case may be, Lord God, you're able to make a way out of no way, oh God. We say make a way out of no way, Lord God, that you be glorified and they be blessed, oh God, that they'll know that you still care. Lord God, all souls belong to you and you care for each and every soul, oh God. We thank you, Lord God, for touching, oh God, for healing, for delivering, for setting the captives free, for opening blind eyes, for unstopping deaf ears, for taking out stony hearts and giving them a heart of flesh. Lord God, we thank you, Lord God, that it's you that animated us this morning, and we thank you for it. And you're welcome in our midst, for you're worthy to be praised. We come to lift you up. We come to magnify your name.
Hallelujah.
Lord God, we thank you that as the praise go out, oh God, even as Saul, Lord, found peace because of the praise and the worship, that those who tormented in their soul find peace, Lord God, and they have a sound mind to make the right decision to come out of that place, Lord God, and to come into you. And we praise you and thank you for victory. We thank you for the word that shall be spoken today. The word is like a hammer, and it breaks the rocks in pieces. We thank you that every soul under the sound of your voice, wherever that stony place is, that the hammer of your word will break the rocks in pieces. We thank you for the burden removing, yoke destroying power, Lord God. We We thank you, Lord God, and we release your Holy Spirit, Lord God, to minister to every soul. For you said, no man come up to God until the Spirit draws him. Lord God, we thank you. As the clarion call go out, Lord God, that they will hear that sound. They will hear that sound and be drawn to you. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Thank you.
Yes, Lord. 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 Y
off today. We're going to cast off the garments of worry, doubt, and fear. We're going to lay everything at his feet. Because everything we worried about or thinking about, there's a benefit to cover it. So as the word comes forth,
hallelujah.
Get your benefits. Claim your benefits. We call Pastor, Brandon Paul. Amen. As he minister, claim your benefits. Amen. And don't let the devil lie and trick you out of what God has already provided for you. Amen. Come on, Brandon Paul. Point your hands toward them. Complete it. You need it. You need it. Put your hands for them. Say, Brandon, Pastor Brandon. Oh, he want the Lord to hear. Pastor Brandon Paul. Give us what the Lord has given you.
Give us what the Lord has given you.
And don't hold back anything.
And don't hold back anything.
And don't be moved by their faces.
And don't be moved by their faces.
Tell the truth.
Tell the truth.
Shame the devil. In the name of Jesus.
Father, we thank and we praise you, Lord God, for the humble honor and privilege to stand before your holy people, sanctified meat for the master's use. Let the words of my mouth, Father, and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. Speak to our hearts in these few moments, Lord God, that which you desire us to hear, that our lives will not be the same. You didn't come to entertain or to tickle the ears of your people, but just to say what heaven wants to say.
Yes.
And so we thank you now.
Thank you.
Not by might nor by the power of man, but by your spirit.
Yes.
Thank you for your word. Glory to God. We give you glory. We give you honor. Glory to God. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Wonderful Jesus. We adore you. We implore you, Lord God. Be God in the midst of us, O God. You are God in the midst of us. So we thank you. And we thank you again. Touch every life. Let your words be like an arrow.
Yes.
shut forth into the hearts of every person.
Yes.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord. Amen. 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 Just tell somebody, I love you.
I love you.
Amen. Just tell, come on, don't miss nobody.
I love you.
Don't leave nobody out. I love you. Amen. God loves you more. You may be seen as wonderful presence. Amen. You may be seen as wonderful presence. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. As Minister Hatton was opening the service, the Lord was opening in the service of what he wanted to say to us this morning in just a few words, but the important words. Thank you all who came with us on last Sunday to lift him up. Amen. And we, by the Spirit of God, affirmed and ordained Apostle Catherine Johnson unto the apostleship. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you for coming and being a part of that awesome move of the Spirit of God.
Amen.
Amen. There's four words I'll give you right away. Be strong, have courage. Be strong, have courage. Amen. I want us to give our attention to a little bit of the reading of God's word, because that's what is commanded of us this day. And you get the pieces that you want, and I'll get the pieces that I want and I need.
Amen.
We're looking at, I'm not so much going to preach a sermon, I'm just going to talk to you by the way. Amen. Is that all right?
Amen.
I'll pick out a few points here that you may need to lay hold of. How many know that we're in the last days, the evil days?
Yes.
And everything is happening all over the United States, all over the world.
Mm-hmm.
We've had about three or four earthquakes this week in different places.
Right.
And we're having floods that are eroding the land and houses falling into the ocean. And, we're having avalanches and we have all kinds of things that are taking place in the land because the earth is upset. The earth is upset. The earth is convulsing, travailing. The earth is travailing, y'all.
Amen.
And we having storms like we never had storms. Alaska got 100 inches of snow.
Amen.
100 inches of snow. I can't even add that.
Amen.
100 inches of snow. How many feet is that? You decide. You know, but 100 inches of snow. Man, and in a few days, 100 inches. We can't even stand, you know, 5 inches, but they got 100 inches, you know. And California is being flooded and roads are falling through and all kind of things are happening. Deuteronomy chapter 34, I just want to read to you this morning, and if that's all I do, you get your spirit charged.
Amen.
Amen. We're not up here to entertain, but to declare God's glory. And the word of the Lord to us is what?
Be strong and have courage.
No, be strong.
And have courage.
Have courage. Be strong, have
courage.
Courage. The Lord is saying to his people, be strong. Have courage. In this time that we are embracing, this is the last days of Moses, and he's about to go off the scene. The Lord's about to give him his funeral services. And so we're just going to look here just for a moment. You can read with me, but the message is,
be strong,
be strong,
and have courage.
I'm hoping you get that. And why am I saying that? Because when you leave here, you're going to have to
be strong and have courage.
Amen.
Ooh, yeah.
I don't know what day of the week you're going to need this, but what week, what month? April, maybe July, maybe August. But the Lord says what?
Be strong and have courage.
Because everything's happening, just like Sister Denise, niece, granddaughter. Amen. You don't know what's going to happen next.
Amen.
That's why we got to pray without ceasing. And trust in God for every day that he gives us and thank him for it. Amen. Praise God. Deuteronomy chapter 34. Father, let the spirit of truth touch every heart, every life. That we never be the same again, in Jesus' name. Verse 1. And Moses went up from the plains of Moab. You can read with me. Unto the mountains of Nebo, to the top of Pisgah that is over against Jericho. And the Lord showed him all the land of Gilead unto Dan, and all Naphtali, and the land of Ephraim and Manasseh, and all the land of Judah unto the uttermost sea, and the south, and the plain of the valley of Jericho, the city of palm trees unto Zoar. And the Lord said unto him, this is the land which I swear unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, saying, I will give it unto thy seed. I have caused thee to see it with thine eyes, but thou shalt not go over thither. After all that work, all that laboring, after all that turmoil and praying and staying the hand of God from destroying this people. He messed up and allowed the people to get on his nerve. And it caused him, as an act of disobedience, to rebel against the word of the Lord that God told him. You got to watch that people don't push you and intimidate you to go against what the word of the Lord has said. Amen. I don't care how tight it is.
Amen.
Stick with the word of the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I don't care what friend or loved one you're going to lose. Stick with the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Amen. If they're going to take back what they gave you, stick with the word of the Lord. The Lord will give you something better.
Amen.
Are you listening this morning? Huh? They promise you something? You can keep it. No. I can't go beyond what God has said. Amen. You can give me all the silver, all the gold you want, but I can't go beyond what thus saith the Lord. Hear the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. Even for your own feeling. Hey, my God, we give you praise. You can't go beyond what he has said. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. That's so important right now. It's important because everything, you know, Satan's going to offer everything. He'll offer you everything. Amen. But you can't receive what he's offering.
Amen.
And so Moses, he messed up. It was his test. The Lord gave him another opportunity. Amen. To show forth his glory.
Yes.
And he was supposed to bring water to the nation. Amen. And he messed up. The Lord allowed him the first, I think that was a baby step of faith, amen, to hit the rock. Amen. And when he hit the rock, water came gushing out of the rock, right?
Right.
The Lord showed him his power. That's power, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Let me see you strike a rock and see if water comes out.
Okay.
But the truth of the matter is that the water came out of the rock, didn't it? Came gushing, flowing out of the rock. So right then, Moses knew that the Lord is the God of his word.
Yes.
He wants what he said.
Yes.
I said he wants what he said.
Yes.
He said what he wants. And so we got to give him what he said and what he wants. Amen.
Amen.
Don't give him something secondary. He wants what he asked for.
Yes,
he wants you to do what he said do. Praise God. And leave the rest, you know, for somebody else. Amen?
Amen.
Praise God. And so he told him this second round to speak to the rock.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, you as intelligent men and women know that a rock don't have ears. But everything God made hears him.
Hallelujah.
Oh God, I praise you. Everything God made, everything Father makes hears his voice.
Amen.
And the stranger, they can't follow. Amen.
Amen.
If you tell a rock to dance, that rock got to get to dancing. Praise God. Praise God. If you tell a donkey to talk, that donkey's got to talk. The donkey ain't supposed to talk human language. Amen. But when God says, it is so, it's already done. It's already, praise God. So if God said it, it's already happening. Praise God. And so if God says something to you, amen, hold on to what God has said. In spite of what man has said, hold on what God's word has said to you. Praise God. So he didn't speak like God said to the rock. You know what God was doing with him? God was elevating his faith.
That's right.
God was bringing him to an elevation of a greater place in himself.
Amen.
It's one thing that he had something to do with water the first time.
Mm-hmm.
But this time, it's going to take all of the power of God.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Because the words that we speak, they are spirit and they are life.
Amen.
Amen. The words you're speaking, they're bringing to you life or they're bringing to you death.
Right.
Amen.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yeah.
The words that I speak, the words that you speak, you have to decide whether they're going to be words of spirit and life.
Amen.
Or sin and death.
Yes.
Are you listening? Praise God. Mm-hmm. Amen. By thy words, Halabah Hoshaya. Jesus said, by thy words thou shalt be justified.
Mm-hmm.
Hmm? And by thy words thou shalt be condemned.
Amen.
Not by somebody else's word, by your words you shall be justified. And by your words, you shall be condemned. Praise God. Don't condemn yourself. Amen.
Amen.
Watch what you say. Be careful how you hear, but be careful what you say.
Yes.
Because you will have what you say. I ain't no good. Well, you won't be no good.
Right.
I ain't going to make it. Well, you ain't going to make it.
Right.
You know? Watch what you say.
Watch.
For by thy words are what?
Justified.
And say, by my words.
By my words.
Come on, say it a little bit louder. By my words.
By my words.
I am justified.
I am justified.
And by my words.
By my words.
Not somebody else's words.
Not somebody else's words.
But by my words.
By my words.
I'm condemned.
I'm condemned.
By your words. God's put the authority in you, John. Put the authority in me. That by my words, I'm justified before him.
Yeah.
And before my fellow brother and sister.
Amen.
Are you listening?
Mm-hmm.
So don't lie against the truth ever.
Mm-hmm.
Amen?
Right.
Huh? Stay with the high road. Praise yeah. God. Don't go low. Michelle Obama said that, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, they go low, we go high. Praise God. Yeah. Praise God. Amen. Stay high.
Come on. Yeah.
Huh? Our conversation in heaven.
Amen.
You're connected to heaven.
Hallelujah.
My God.
Hallelujah.
I said you connected to heaven. Heaven's yeah. listening to you. Hey! My God, heaven's listening to you. My God, heaven's hearing your words.
Amen.
Attending to your words. Hearkening to the voice of your words. The angels will come for your words. The angels coming for your words. And to bring them to pass.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Amen. Are you listening?
Amen.
And so Moses, he lost out of going into the promised land. He's able to see it, but he couldn't partake of it because he dishonored God before the people. God don't play with his authority.
Amen.
I said God doesn't play with his authority.
Amen.
He may give you one pass, but I can't say he may, but you don't want to sidestep what God has said.
Amen.
Because it's life.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Can we go on? Verse 4 says, and the Lord said unto him, what did he say? This is the land which I swear unto Abraham, unto Isaac, and unto Jacob, saying, I will give it unto thy seed. I have caused thee to see it with thine eyes, but thou shalt not go over thither. You can't go in, Moses.
Amen.
He asked him a couple of times. No, it ain't happening, son. No. Verse 5. So Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in the land of Moab, according to the word of the Lord. And he buried him in a valley in the land of Moab, over against Beth Peor, but no man knoweth of his sepulcher unto this day. God is wise, isn't he? Because they would have propped him up and made him an idol. They were trying to get all kinds of stuff out of something that was already gone. Now, God is wise. He knows us. Praise God. You remember when Moses went up in the mountain, praise God, they couldn't wait until he got back? Cause a leader to go crazy and make something that God made to worship it. How crazy is that? You'll go to your backyard, cut down a tree, and go and bow before it.
Wow.
Can't see, can't hear, can't speak. That's insanity. Come on.
Yes. Amen.
See, that's what we do with stuff.
Yeah.
We idolize stuff and we worship stuff and lose our mind.
Yes.
We idolize people and lose our mind. Praise God. I can't live without them. You better learn how to.
Amen.
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 All right. Hmm?
Yeah, because God will remove that. He'll take it from you, or you'll.
Yes.
Then what you gonna do?
We.
Praise God. Let's be careful in these last days. Amen. Making idols of this one, idols of that one. Amen. Praise God. I can't live without him. I can't live without him. Glory to God.
Yes.
I'm giving you soul food this morning to help you stay alive.
Amen.
Praise God. And there's many enemies out there. And as I was this morning before the Lord, there's many wiles of the devil.
Yeah.
I'll try to get to that in a minute, but so Moses, the servant of the Lord, verse 5, so Moses, the servant of the Lord, died there in the land of Moab, according to the word of the Lord, and he buried him in a valley in the land of Moab, over against Beth Peor, but no man knoweth of his sepulcher unto this day. Read the word. And Moses was 120 years old when he died. His eyes were not dim, nor his natural force abated. Nor his natural force abated. Everything was working.
Yes.
My God, what a good God.
Amen.
This now listen. This didn't come cheap though. I'm gonna get that. No, listen. This didn't come cheap.
Amen.
It came by him walking in integrity with the Lord.
Yes.
It came by him keeping time with the Lord. Amen.
Yes.
Not hit and miss. Yeah, maybe I'll talk to him today. Maybe I won't talk today. No, it was a consistency of relationship. It was intimate relationship that they had together. Praise God. You know, we want to take everything we see in Scripture and say it's ours. But what kind of life are you living? Amen. What kind of, time you spending with him? Praise God. In your walk, in your talk, amen. In your thoughts, praise God.
Amen.
All that caused everything to work together for its good, amen.
Amen.
The Bible says all things work together. Yeah. Everything in you have to work in concert, amen.
Amen.
With truth, praise God.
Yes.
Amen. You got to keep it lined up, praise God.
Right.
My God, we thank you. And so Moses was what? 120 years old when he died. His eyes was not dim, nor his natural force abated. And the children of Israel wept for Moses in the plains of Moab 30 days. So the days of weeping and mourning for Moses were ended. Amen. And Joshua, the son of Nun, was full of the spirit of wisdom. Wow. He's full of the spirit of wisdom, for Moses had laid his hands upon him, and the children of Israel hearkened unto him and did as the Lord commanded Moses. Now, understand, amen, the laying on of hands, the ministry of laying on of hands, there's an impartation that comes with the laying on of hand of commissioned ministers of the gospel. Amen. God allows the virtue, a release of his virtue, of his blessing, that's upon that man or woman of God to be transferred unto an individual. Praise God.
Amen.
Are you listening?
Mm-hmm.
And so when we lay hands upon you, praise God, we're believing God, there's a transference of what is God's stuff will come on you. Praise
amen.
God.
Yeah.
Amen. And there's nothing good of myself, but what God gives me, amen, and put it on you. Praise God. And your life will be different. Praise God. Or elevated to another place. Amen.
Yeah,
but you got to believe it. Amen. You can't do it. Ain't nothing going to happen. Well, ain't nothing going to happen. Don't look for nothing. Don't expect nothing. You got to believe that you receive, then you shall have. I said, you got to believe that you receive, then you shall have. Praise God. And so the scripture is saying clearly that the ministry of laying on hands is in order. Praise God.
Amen.
But you have to come to order and come to agreement. Praise God.
Amen.
Praise God. If somebody lay your hands on me, say, "When I use Elder Field. Elder Field lay hands on me, I'm going to get something from God."
Amen.
I ain't coming up here thinking ain't nothing going to happen. No, when he lays hands on me, something's going to happen. Huh? Something going to get a hold of me. Praise God. Hey. I ain't gonna never be the same again. Praise God. Hey, my God, don't come with doubtful disputation. Amen. Come with a believing heart. Praise God. Amen. You ain't got all that you need. No. Somebody has something for you. Amen. Praise God to give you, my God, a boost. Amen. Bring you to another level. Amen. Bring you to an elevation. Amen. Of a greater peace of God. Ah, yeah. Yeah, don't think you got it all.
Amen.
No, I want more. Praise God.
Yes,
I say I want more of him.
More.
Praise God forevermore.
More.
Praise God. And so I want you to keep on believing. Believe all what he said. Praise God. Verse 9 said, and Joshua the son of Nun was full of the spirit of wisdom, for Moses had laid his hand upon him, and the children of Israel hearkened unto him, and did as the Lord commanded Moses. Did the Lord command what?
Moses.
Turn to Numbers 27. I want to show you something. And Numbers 27, where this took place. Numbers 27. Praise God. What's God saying to us this morning?
Be strong and have courage.
Mm-hmm. Be what?
Be strong and have courage.
Mm-hmm. Just tell your neighbor that. Come on, tell your neighbor that.
Be strong and have courage.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, have courage. Can I just say this? Don't wimp out.
Amen.
Don't wimp out. When you're challenged. Don't change your mind when you're challenged. You know, it's challenges are coming. Don't wimp out. Praise God. You got number 27? This is dealing with the commission of Moses to Joshua. Looking at verse 15. And Moses had a good heart towards the Lord and towards the people of God. He didn't want the people to be without a shepherd.
Amen.
He knew that God was going to take them, so he's making provision.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Verse 15, it says what?
Amen.
And Moses spake unto the Lord, saying, let the Lord, the God of spirits of all flesh, send a man over the congregation, which may go out before them, and which may go in before them, and which may lead them out, and which may bring them in, that the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep which have no shepherd. Now, that's very important. This verse is very important. I'm going to read it again. And Moses spake unto the Lord, saying, let the Lord, the God of the spirits of all flesh, send a man over the congregation. Here's what he's going to do. Which may go out before them.
Mm-hmm.
And which may go in before them. And which may lead them out, and which may bring them in, that the congregation of the Lord be not as sheep which have no
shepherd.
My. So the Lord gives you a shepherd, amen, for protection.
Amen.
For warning.
Thank you, Lord.
For wisdom, praise God. And understanding of the times, praise God.
Thank you.
And what to look for.
Yes,
and so, and to keep you in a place of peace,
yes.
And joy,
yes.
Amen. All that's encompassed about, amen, being a shepherd, amen. Amen. And so he's giving them instruction, amen, because there's enemies out there.
Yes, yes.
There's enemies out there.
Yes.
You can't be going everywhere and listen to everybody, amen. Praise God. Amen. You've got to be particular, amen. Yes. Because you get a hold of some buzzard seed and you'd be all buzzing around here like you lost your mind.
Amen.
Huh?
Amen.
So you don't want that. Praise God. Verse 18 says, and the Lord said unto Moses, take thee Joshua the son of Nun, a man in whom is the Spirit. He had the Spirit.
Yes, yes.
See, don't get it twisted. You have the Spirit, but you may not have all the extras that go with of what you have.
That's right.
Yes. Praise God. And the Lord said to Moses, take thee Joshua the son of Nun, a man in whom the Spirit, and lay thy hand upon him. Lay your hand upon him. And set him before Eleazar the priest and before all the congregation, and give him a charge in their sight. And thou shalt not, now thou shalt put some of, ooh, hold up, didn't say all? Now I'm going to give you a little taste, a little dab of do you, praise God, you know. I know all y'all greedy for, you want it all, give it all. Lord. Then you killed your crazy self, praise God. You be pointing your fingers, killing this one, killing that one, and starting wars here, wars there, amen. God, I got the power, I got the power. No, God, he will just give you power, amen. He'll drive you crazy and everybody else, praise God. Mm. Where am I at? I'm at 19, right? I'm going back to 8:19. And set him before Eleazar the priest and before all the congregation, and give him a charge in their
sight.
In their
sight.
I want everybody here. And thou shalt put some of thy honor upon him. So let's be careful. Mm-hmm. Amen. There's tiers of leadership and authority.
That's right.
Hmm? Don't ever get beside yourself. And you want to get above your leader.
Yes.
And though you may have a whole lot of good stuff in you, but you can hurt yourself. Amen.
Yeah.
And think you're higher in authority above. Amen.
Yes.
Your leader. Praise God. You got to watch yourself in that. Praise God. Praise God. Yeah, don't sidestep, amen. Don't elevate yourself above where you aim. Praise God. Are you listening? Praise God. You know, it's important, amen. That's why there's boundaries and limits, praise God, that God has set.
Amen.
Boundaries and limits. See, everybody, you need boundaries. You need limits,
amen.
And like Apostle said, you don't need to be flying by the seat of your pants.
Amen.
And not under authority. Praise God.
Amen.
Let every soul be subject unto the higher authorities. Uh-huh.
Yeah, yeah.
Praise God. Why? Because it'll keep you safe.
That's right.
It'll keep you safe. Praise God.
Glory.
I like being safe. Praise God.
Amen.
Where am I at? 20?
Yeah.
And thou shalt put some of thine honor upon him, that all the congregation of the children of Israel may be obedient. Lord wants us to be obedient.
Amen.
All of us. Not you sit in the pews, I want from the pit to the back of the door. Everybody be obedient.
Amen.
Praise God. Nobody get a lucky ticket. Verse 21, and he shall stand before Eleazar the priest, who shall ask counsel for him after the judgment of the Urim before the Lord. At his word, hold up, here you go, this is good. At his word shall they go out, and at his word they shall come in, both he and all the children of Israel with him, even all the congregation. And Moses did as the Lord commanded him, and took Joshua and set him before Eleazar the priest and before all the congregation. And he laid his hands upon him and gave him a charge
as the Lord commanded by the
hands of Moses. The Lord commanded Moses.
Right.
Praise God. God gives commands.
Amen.
I said God gives commands.
Amen.
Praise God. He gives orders. Praise God. If you don't want to be in order, then you can't walk with God. God is a God of order, a plan, a design. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. And when we talk about this book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth or thy heart, it's a book of love, the law of love. God's book is a book, it's a love law. I say it like that. God's law is a love law. You know why God wrote his law?
Because he loved.
Huh? That's one point, but the highest point, to keep you and I from killing ourselves.
Hallelujah.
Or killing each other. Because you can't mess with him. And you his least worry, but he wrote the laws to protect us from one another.
Yeah.
To keep us all in order.
Jesus.
Hmm? Mm-hmm. Amen. That's why, yeah. He made a law for himself. He needs a law for you and me with each other. Just go and look at the book of the law, you know? It helps us understand how to respect and honor each other. Mm-hmm. Amen. How to treat one another.
Amen.
Amen. Even treating the land, how to treat the land right. Glory to God. Now, did I finish that? And he laid his hands upon him and gave him a charge as the Lord commanded by the hand of Moses. Back to Joshua. Deuteronomy, yeah, finish Deuteronomy. Amen. We stopped at
nine.
Amen. Deuteronomy 34, 9. Wanted to read, and Joshua the son of Nun was full of the spirit of wisdom, for Moses had laid his hands upon him, and the children of Israel hearkened unto him, and did as the Lord commanded Moses. My God, why? Because there was an impartation unto Joshua. Mm-hmm. What did Joshua get from Moses?
Wisdom.
He got some honor from him. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and all that entailed was wisdom. But he gave him honor to walk in a place of godness.
Amen.
Mm. Amen. He imparted honor to him, and the people seemed honored upon Joshua. Amen.
Amen.
And there arose not a prophet, verse 10, and there arose not a prophet since in Israel, like unto Moses, whom the Lord knew. Whom the Lord knew. See, the Lord don't know everybody face to face. He give some of his prophets dreams.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Some he give visions.
Yeah.
Praise God. And some he speaks in the ear.
Mm-hmm.
But then others he speak mouth to mouth.
Mm-hmm.
Are you listening? Mm-hmm. And sometimes he speak by angelic being.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, so different levels of authority, different levels of God's revealing of himself to his people.
Mm-hmm.
Are you understanding that?
Yes.
And so the way he revealed himself to you may not be the way he revealed himself to somebody else.
Amen.
And so he made a statement, listen, because they got beside themselves, some leaders got beside themselves because God was talking to them. But, I talk to y'all, but I don't talk to you like I talk to my servant Moses. I may give you dreams and vision, but this boy I talk to face to face. Amen.
Right, right, right.
You should have been afraid, amen, to put your mouth against him. Praise God. Yeah, they trying to put their mouth on the man of God. Praise God. They didn't know what kind of relationship he had with God.
Amen.
You better be careful who you put your mouth on. Praise God. You may be touching God's heart. Praise God.
Amen.
And so, yeah, he spoke to him face to face. Verse 11, in all the signs and wonders which the Lord sent him to do in the land of Egypt to Pharaoh and to all his servants and to all his land, and in all that mighty hand and in all the great terrors which Moses showed in the sight of all Israel. Praise God. Praise God. Praise the name of our God. Joshua chapter 1 and 2, let's read. Now after the death of Moses, the servant of the Lord, it came to pass that the Lord spake unto Joshua, the son of Nun, Moses' minister, saying,
Moses,
Moses, my servant, is dead. Now, therefore, arise, go over this Jordan, thou and all this people, unto the land which I do give to them, even to the children of Israel. I give them. They don't have to buy it. They don't have to beg for it. They don't have to steal. Amen. Bargain. No, I'm giving this to them.
Hallelujah.
That's what God says.
That's what he said.
Praise God. I love God, how he gives you stuff. Yeah. My God. Verse 3 said, every place that the sole of your foot shall tread upon, that have I given unto you, as I said unto Moses. I'm giving this stuff to you. But what if somebody else is there? Well, they're about to move. Amen. I said, I'm going to give it to you. Praise God. The time is up. Lease is up. Say, it's mine. Yeah, God be thank you. You know, there's some stuff out there for you. God got some stuff for you. Praise God. God got some blessings for you. Praise God. As you continue to walk with him. God got some things he's going to show you. Praise God. As you walk humbly before him. Praise God. This is not all there is. Hallelujah. I said, this is not all there is. Praise God. There's much more of God to be had. Thank you, Jesus. Don't be satisfied. Hey, my God, we thank you. Glory to God. Glory to God. You know, the Bible says that the cattle on 1,000 hills is his. Got to get a couple of cows, God? What y'all talking about? Yeah, at least one, two. If you got, oh, let me go on. Where are we at? 4. Verse 4, from the wilderness and this Lebanon, even unto the great river, the river Euphrates, all the land of the Hittites, and unto the great sea, towards the going down of the sun, shall be your coast. God says it's going to be yours. Mm-mm. God's a good God to his people. Verse 5 says, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee nor forsake thee. Can I say that the word of the Lord is coming to me, to this people?
Yes.
From this word to you?
Yes.
God doesn't do a sila, sila, or truly, truly, amen, if he's not going to do something.
Yes.
I'm over there minding my own business, you know, worshiping the Lord, amen. And this girl gets up here and reading my verse. And the Lord said, you smell the coffee?
Amen.
I'm saying, Lord, my leg's a little wobbly. Lord, my, you know, I don't know if I can stand you. Are you smelling the coffee? You can rest legs later.
Jesus.
Lord, are you going to stand today?
Amen.
I told him to be ready, praise God. He was ready, praise God, but he got bumped. We're going to obey the Lord, praise God.
Amen.
This is your verse.
Amen.
Ain't nobody got excited. Gloria, this is your verse. Cynthia, this is your verse. Come on. Donald, you want this? Somebody better say, this is mine. Hey! My God, this is mine. My God, yeah. When God's given stuff, you better take it. Praise God. In the mouth of 2 or 3 witnesses, let every word be established. Amen. He's established something this morning, this 11th day of the second month of 2024, the year of the open door. God's open door. Praise God. The door is open unto you. Praise God. My God. And what he's saying here in verse 5, I know he said it 2,000 years ago, how many thousand years ago it was, but his word is nigh thee, even in my mouth and my heart, what I'm preaching to you this morning.
Yeah.
He's saying, I'm the same God.
Same God.
I am the same God,
same God,
and I don't change, amen?
Amen.
I'm not going to be better to them than I am going to be to you. Not so. I'm the same.
Yeah.
Yesterday, today, and for?
Hallelujah.
Yeah. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
You don't change.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
Glory to God.
See, we're in the last days, and they're evil days. And so you need this peace right here.
Yes.
Amen.
Show up and show up. Come on.
And when the evening was come, they brought many that were possessed with the devils.
Yes.
And what else happened?
With his word.
He cast up spirits up with his word. He healed all that were sick, huh? That it might be what? Fulfilled, which was spoken by the prophet, Isaiah the prophet, saying himself. That's what he did. That's what he said. That's what he did. He took.
Yes, he did.
He took. Meaning to carry away and bear in his own body every sickness, every disease, all manner of sickness, all manner of disease.
Hallelujah.
Huh? And he's going to make it good. He's going to make it good. Hey, my God, he's going to make it good. My God. Yeah, excuse me, you know, but there's something comes up, and so I'm not doing it on purpose. There's something in my belly. Just have to come out, and I have to release it out. Praise God. Glory to God. It's like a lightning effect. Amen. Something shooting out. Hey, my God. I pray it strike everybody in this room. Glory to God. My God. He can do something in one moment, and your life can be changed. One word from God can change your very future, your destiny. Just because you had an open and believing and honest heart. Huh? That's the good ground. Honest and sincere heart. It's what God has. Verse 5 says, there shall not any man be able to stand before thee all the days of thy life, Joshua. As I was with Moses, so I will be with thee. I will not fail thee, nor forsake thee. Jesus said, Lord, I'm with you always. Matthew 28, the last. I'm with you always, even to the end of the world, the age, amen, that you're in. I'm with you.
Hallelujah.
And if I'm with you, I'm more than the whole world against you at the same time.
Amen.
If I'm for you, if I'm with you.
Amen.
Yes.
I believe God this morning, y'all. I believe God's word this morning to us this morning.
Hallelujah.
What did he tell us to do? What? Have what?
Have
be what?
Be strong.
And have what?
Courage.
Have courage. Be strong and have what?
Courage.
Amen. Where we at? Verse 6. Here we go. Read. Be strong and of good
courage.
Be strong and of what?
Good courage.
Oh my God. Be strong. All right. Be strong.
Be strong.
Mm-hmm. Not easily affected.
Amen.
Or upset.
Amen.
So you got to know what that means. Not easily affected. Or upset, not easily intimidated.
Amen. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Be strong.
Be strong. Mm-hmm.
Don't let nobody affect your stand.
Amen.
Or upset your spirit.
Right. Come on.
In your patience. Tomorrow possess ye your soul in your patience of waiting on the Lord. Possess your soul. Keep the reins of your soul intact. Don't get all whacked out. Amen.
Amen.
Hold on to the reins of your soul. Your mind, will, and emotions. Amen. in your patience, waiting for the Lord to do what he said he's going to do. Possess, my God, your soul. Keep it intact. Amen. Don't give a piece of your mind away. You can't lose. You can't afford to lose none of it. No. No. The more you lose, the less you have to deal with the devil. Huh? Hold on to every piece you got. Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Strong means not easily affected or upset. Huh? Strong means he wants you to be morally powerful.
Amen.
Morally powerful.
Mm-hmm. He wants you having strength of character or will. Mm-hmm. Having strength of character and will. He wants your will to be strong. Mm. You know, not by yourself.
Right.
Yeah. 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 Paul said in Ephesians 6:10, finally, my brother, be strong in the Lord. And in the power of the might of what he has said.
Yeah.
Hmm? Yeah. Finally. Be.
Be.
I looked that up too. I look up every word. I look up every word. Let me see if I got it here somewhere. I be writing and looking. And I want to know what everything means. I want to get all my stuff. I'll get to it more. Yes, I know it's here. Stay strong.
Strong.
Not easily affected or upset.
Not easily affected.
Morally powerful.
Morally powerful.
Having strength of character or will. Mm-hmm.
Be strong.
Mm-hmm. Able to think vigorously and clearly.
Amen.
Hmm? Able to think vigorously and clearly. Having competence and ability. Be strong. Able to resist and endure attacks. Able to what? Resist and endure attacks. Attacks come. God wants you to be able to what?
Resist.
And endure attacks. People will try to attack your character.
Thank you, Jesus.
Strong. Governing or leading with godly authority and strength.
Amen.
Strong governing or leading with godly authority and strength. What did God say to us?
Be strong and have courage.
Be strong and have courage. Be strong and have what?
Courage.
Courage. The attitude of facing and dealing with anything recognized as dangerous, difficult, or painful instead of withdrawing.
Amen.
I'm going to say it again. Courage, the attitude of facing and dealing with anything recognized as dangerous, difficult, or painful instead of withdrawing.
Amen.
Or running.
Amen.
There's difficulties in this life. There's painful days sometime in this life. Huh?
Oh, yes.
We're not in Alice Wonderland. We're talking about real living.
Amen.
Ask Apostle Paul. Ask Peter. Praise God. Huh? That tell you what it really means to be, you know, God. I'm glad God had me back there.
Amen.
Man, folk with nine flies back there, you know. They, man. Say courage.
Courage.
The quality of being fearless or brave.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
What did God say to us?
Be strong and have courage.
Be strong and have courage. The quality of being fearless or brave. face of adversity. Courage, the courage of one's conviction.
Amen.
Have courage in your convictions.
Yes.
Have courage to stand fast in your convictions of what you believe.
Amen.
Don't let anybody move you from what you believe, your convictions.
Amen.
The your convictions.
Yes.
Hold on to your convictions. Praise God. Amen. Praise the name of our God. Courage to do what one thinks is right. Courage having to, you got, this is good. Courage to do what one thinks is right, even if everybody else is doing the other thing.
Amen.
Have courage to do what thing is right by being courageous.
Amen.
Even they try to bully you.
Amen.
I ain't gonna do it. I ain't gonna believe that.
Amen.
Having or showing courage, brave. Thank you, Jesus. Again, Paul said like this, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Why? Because the scripture says, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high
places.
Be strong, have courage. Be strong, have courage. Why? Because there are demon powers in people.
Yes.
Whom Satan has control over. Some and others. Who have submitted themselves willingly as an act of their own will. As an act of their own will. They know what they're doing. And there's some benefits to them. Come on, the devil gives benefits. He gives gifts.
Yes, he does.
Amen. I said he gives gifts.
Amen.
All right.
Be strong.
Be strong.
Have faith. Back to Joshua. Joshua 1. Couple more verses. Have faith.
Have faith.
And be strong. Have courage. We stop at verse. Which one do y'all want?
Six.
All right, you're reading.
No.
Okay. Verse 6, wanted to read, be strong and of good courage, for unto this people shall thou divide an inheritance land which I swear unto their fathers to give them. Only be thou, you have no choice, only. Come on, only. Tell your neighbor, only. You have no choice, no other option, only. My God, only. Amen. No. Joel said, let the weak say, I'm strong.
Yeah, I'm strong.
Let the poor say, I'm
rich.
Glory to God. Verse 7, that only be thou strong and very
courageous.
Very
courageous.
That thou mayest observe. Thou mayest what?
Observe to do.
I like that word observe. I always like looking at that word observe. Praise God. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. Only be thou strong and very courageous, that thou mayest what? Observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded thee. Turn not from it to the right hand or to the left, that thou mayest prosper, whithersoever thou goest. Don't turn from the right or the left of what God has said to you, Adrena.
Amen.
That's not racist, is it?
Amen.
Donald? Don't turn from the right or the left, which you have believed that God said to you.
Hallelujah.
Don't turn to the left or the right. Stay in the center of his will.
Yes.
And you will prosper.
Yes.
Huh? Mm-hmm. It may not be like your brother or sister, but you're going to prosper in the hand of God.
Amen.
Your life is your life. My life is my life. Amen. Come on. We come from different backgrounds. Amen. Praise
yes.
God.
Yes.
Stop looking at somebody and say they should be like you or do what you do. No, they come from another
Amen.
Place. Amen. In life. Amen. Praise God. Another world. Amen. Praise God. And they didn't come up like you came up. Praise God. But God will take them where they're supposed to go, like he's going to take you where you're supposed to go. Amen.
Amen.
Praise God. We're not clones. Praise God. I said we're not clones. Amen. Praise God. I'm thunder. My wife is lightning. She don't make as much noise as I make. Amen. But still, it gets the same effect. Praise God. It gets the job done. Praise God. Praise God. Amen. She may point her finger and release the power of God. I mean, holler. Blow the devil up. Praise God.
As
long as he get blown up. Praise God. Praise God. Where are we at? Verse 7. This is important. Because somebody's going to try to take your strength. Someone's going to try to take the word of the Lord out of your mouth. That's trying to get to your heart. The devil comes when the word is sown to take it right out of your heart. Amen. Before it takes root. Praise God. You thought you believed God, but you didn't give it time to grow. Amen. Just stay down there. Amen. Yeah, I believe in the Lord. I believe on the Lord. But you got to keep on believing in the Lord.
Amen.
I said you got to keep on believing in the Lord.
Yeah.
Jesus said in the 8th chapter of John, if you continue in my word,
Amen.
If you continue in my word, then shall you be my disciples indeed, and you shall know the truth.
Yeah.
And the truth that you know and hold on to will make you free.
Amen.
Something you can get off, get on, get off, no. You got to stay in.
Oh, yes.
You got to continue.
Oh, yes.
He said it, I didn't.
Amen.
If you continue in my word, then
Amen.
Shall you be my disciples indeed, and you shall know it. Mm-hmm. Verse 8, we read 8 now, come on. Did I finish 7?
Yes. No.
Let's finish 7, then we'll go on to 8. Now I'm almost done. What did the Lord say to us this morning?
Be strong and have courage.
What did he say?
Be strong and have courage.
Be strong and have courage. There's a terror attack coming to the United States. And God's warning us right now to be ready.
Yes.
I said there's a terror attack coming upon the United States. And he wants us to be ready in our very spirit. I gave the word of the Lord that God gave me last Wednesday. Revelations 12:12. You remember that? Let's turn to it right quick before I sit down. Revelations 12. This is important because I was minding my own business. 2 days in a row kept coming up in my spirit. And I said, okay, Lord, you want me to, say it? We'll say it. Then I got the word about the terror attack coming upon the United States. The next morning, that Sunday morning, before we went to the service. You got Revelation 12?
Amen.
Verse 12 says, therefore, rejoice ye heavens and ye that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you having great wrath, because he knoweth that he hath but a
short time.
He knoweth that but a
short time.
He has a short time. So whatever he's going to do, he's going to try to do it quickly to whoever he can do it unto. To unbelieving, undoubtful men and women who won't believe God or hold on to what God said. He said, whoa.
Whoa.
My God. Warning.
You remember that warning. Yeah, lost in space, praise God. Yeah, woe unto the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil has come down having great wrath. Why? Because he knows that he has but a short time to work. And if he can work your nerve, my brother and my sister, he going to send everything to try to work your nerve and to work the gospel out of your heart and to work truth out of you, amen, and work a lie in there, amen. Praise God. Well, you forgot the truth and you believe in a lie now. Hallelujah. My God. Hold fast the profession of your faith without wavering.
Amen.
For he is faithful that promise. He will do everything that he said he would do just for you and me.
Yes.
Glory to God.
Yes, Lord.
Back to Joshua chapter 1. I just want you to see that. Make that as a note. No. You know? Yeah. Yeah. We got some folk. We got some folk don't even believe it's the devil. I said we got some folk don't even believe it's the devil. Well, I don't listen to those folk. I hold on to what my master said.
Amen.
Amen. You know when Peter's trying to persuade him not to go to the cross?
Yes.
He's saying, you ain't going to do that, Lord. That ain't happening. Mm-hmm. He called him a devil.
Yes, he did.
Huh? And he lost his mind. It's a few little seconds. He lost his mind. You know? But then he told him one time, he said, Peter, you know, Satan has desired to sift you as wheat. Now, he said it, I didn't say it. He said, Satan has desired to sift you as wheat, but I pray for you that your faith fail not. That when you converted, you will strengthen your brother. Amen? Praise God. My God. So Jesus said, there is a devil. Amen? Come on. And Lord, keep praying for me. Lord, keep praying for Richard. Come on. Keep interceding for Richard. I need you to intercede for me. Praise God. I don't want to fail you, Lord. I don't want to fail. Praise God. See, I'm a disciple just like you. Amen.
Amen.
Lord, even me. Pray for me. Praise God.
Amen.
Now, you don't want your faith to fail.
That's right.
So he said it, it means it can happen, right?
Amen.
Take note. If he said it, it means it can happen.
Right.
But you got to hold on. By being what?
Strong.
And courage.
I stop at verse
8.
This book of the law shall not depart out of thy
mouth,
but thou shalt meditate therein day and
night,
that thou mayest observe to do according to all that's written therein. For
then
thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and
then
thou shalt have Father's heart is that we have good success.
Amen.
Our way be made prosperous. Amen.
Amen.
That's Father God's heart for me.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm going to lay hold of all that. Come on.
Yeah.
Praise God.
Yeah.
I want to read it again.
Uh-huh.
So you got to do what it's saying, though.
Yeah.
This book of the law shall not depart out of
my mouth.
But I shall meditate therein day and
night.
That I mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For I shall make my way, and then
I shall have
good success. Then he goes, verse 9. Have not I commanded thee?
Be strong.
This is the third time he's saying this. He's making sure that you and I have this.
Amen.
He said it in verse 6.
Yes.
Be strong and of good courage.
Yes.
He said in verse 7.
Amen.
Only be thou strong and very courageous.
Amen.
He kicked it up a notch, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
I said he kicked it up a notch.
Yes.
Oh my God, I got more power, y'all. Oh my God. Now catch that. He just said be courageous, but
very
courageous.
Very.
What did Emerald say? Emerald Gossi say? You got to
put
some bang on it.
Oh. Yeah.
Come on. Right? Come on.
Yeah.
You got to put something to it. Praise God. You ain't a little dab, but do you?
Right?
Today, right? Put some bang on it. Come on.
Bam.
Praise God.
Bam.
shall know it. That's the second time he said it. But then we go to 9. Have not I commanded thee, be strong and of good courage. Make sure it's good courage. Huh? Not crying courage.
That's right.
Good courage. Huh? Joyous courage. That you win.
Hallelujah.
Come on, joyous courage, right? Huh? Not this oh me, oh my courage. No, joyous courage. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. This is the kind of courage you want. Come on. Have not I commanded thee? Read 9. Have not I commanded thee? Be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou go. The Lord God is with thee whithersoever thou go. Don't ever leave the house without taking the Lord with you. And if he's with you, amen, everybody better get back. Praise God. How many in this room believe the Lord is with you? Raise your hand. Wave your hand at me. Come on, if you really believe the Lord is with you, praise God. You ain't got nothing to fear. Praise God.
That's right.
Praise God. I'm going to read it one more time because this is the message this morning. What's the message?
Be strong and have courage.
When?
Now.
Right now.
Right now.
Can I tell you, when you leave out of here, the test is on.
Oh, yes.
I don't care what your big name is.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
If God brought this, I mean, he wants you to be
strong.
He wants you to be molded into this word and be on guard.
Amen.
And be warned that there's an enemy out there. He wants to rob, steal, kill, and destroy your footing.
Amen.
He can do it by one act.
Mm-hmm.
If you're not
strong
and have courage.
Amen.
I stop at verse 9. Have not I commanded thee, be strong and of good courage. Be not afraid, neither be thou dismayed. For the Lord thy God is with thee whithersoever thou goest. Read. Then Joshua commanded the officers of the people, saying, pass through the host and command the people, saying, prepare you victuals, for within 3 days ye shall pass over this Jordan to go in to possess the land which the Lord your God giveth you to possess it. And to the Reubenites and to the Gadites and to half the tribe of Manasseh spake Joshua, saying, remember the word which Moses, the servant of the Lord, commanded you, saying, the Lord your God hath given you rest and hath given you this land. They were on the side of the land. Did Brother go over? All right. Your wives, your little ones, and your cattle shall remain in the land which Moses gave you on this side of Jordan. But ye shall pass before your brethren armed, all the mighty men of valor, and help them. Until the Lord hath given your brethren rest, as he hath given you, and they also have possessed the land which the Lord your God hath given them, then ye shall return unto the land of your possession and enjoy it, which Moses the Lord's servant gave you on this side Jordan towards the sunrise. Now, they're going to go help their brother and sister. We are helpers of one another.
Amen.
I said we're helpers of one another. Praise Amen. God. Always remember that.
Amen.
You're not an island by your own self. Praise
Amen.
God.
Amen.
He made us to be like that.
Yes.
One unto another.
Amen.
Read the word.
And they
answered Joshua, saying, all that thou commandest us, we will do. And whithersoever thou sendest us, we will go. According as we hearken unto Moses in all things, so will we hearken unto thee. Here we go. Here's the key. Only the Lord thy God be with thee as he was with Moses. This is the only stipulation. That the Lord has to, the same God that was with Moses, he's got to be with you. That's all right, right?
Yeah.
if they're going to obey, they're going to be submitted.
That's right.
And we want the same deal that Moses had.
Amen.
Or forget it.
Right.
Is this same God going to split a sea?
Mm-hmm.
And we're with you.
Yeah.
Is this same God going to destroy all the enemies?
Mm-hmm.
No, we're with you.
That's right.
Hmm. Verse 17, according as we hearken unto Moses in all things, so will we hearken unto thee. Only the Lord thy God be with thee as he was with Moses. And whosoever he be that do rebel against thy commandment and will not hearken unto thy words and all that thou commandest him, he shall be put to death. Only be thou strong and of good courage. Only be thou
strong
and of
good courage.
And of good courage.
Yes, thank you. Woo.
Thank you.
Thank you, Jesus. I rose to tell you, God says, be strong.
Be strong.
Have courage.
Have courage.
Woo. Making sure I get my pieces. As Paul said this in my closing, finally, brethren, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that ye may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Wiles are tricks or manipulations designed to deceive you. Wiles are tricks or manipulations designed to deceive you. Mm. They come not only in the invisible spirit world, but in the natural world, where people will try to manipulate you and trick you to get you in a place where you're not strong any longer or courageous.
Mm-hmm.
But wiles are tricks or manipulations designed to deceive you.
Mm.
Wiles are those clever schemes used by Satan through people to ensnare you or us through temptations, threats, or intimidations.
Wow.
They're out there.
Yeah.
Are you listening? I'm just going to give you one, and I'll be done because this is the most important one. A wile. This is the most important wile of the devil that you need to hear. The enemy, through your mind or through people, challenges God's word. The challenging of God's word that's in your heart.
Mm-hmm.
That's a wild of the devil.
Yes, it is.
He'll say, just like he said to our first parents, have God said?
We.
You immediately say, yeah, he said.
That's right.
What of it?
That's right.
No, you don't let me think about it. No, yeah, he said, yeah.
That's right.
Well, what you got to say about it?
Amen.
And look at me like, what you got to say about it, huh?
Right.
Take your glass off. You can't see.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, he did say, what are you trying to say?
Okay.
You got to deal with the devil, amen.
Yeah, that's right.
You got to answer me, amen.
That's right, sir.
No?
Yes.
What's up?
God said.
Get in his face. No, no, he did say, yeah.
That's right.
What are you saying?
Right.
So that's a wile of the devil.
What you said.
A challenging of God's word. Did God really say? Yeah, he did say that. Yeah.
He did.
You want me to take it there?
What about it? Okay. Amen.
listen carefully. The devil will invite you or me to reconsider what God has said.
All the time. We.
If we're not strong and courageous in what God has said.
Amen.
Can I say it again?
Yes.
The devil will invite you or me to reconsider what God has said. If we're not strong and courageous.
Absolutely.
See, Jesus is trying to help us out. Listen, if he came to me, he's coming to you.
Yeah. That's right. That's right.
He ain't no respecter of person. He's coming to you.
Yeah.
He's going to pull your card. And he's going to ask you, if thou be a believer, if thou be a son of God, he's going to ask you if you really are a son of God. Yeah, he asked Jesus, if thou be a son, I am the son of God.
What's up?
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah. If thou be, I am.
Amen.
What are you?
Right.
Amen.
Amen.
Didn't he ask Jesus that? If thou be a son of God? If thou be a son of God? Yeah. He's trying to get him to reconsider.
Right.
He don't know who you're dealing with. I know who I'm dealing with. I made you. Praise God. I only obey one voice. You're trying to tell him. I only obey one voice. Praise God. Listen. I know who I am. I know where I come from. I know where I'm going. Praise God. Do you know who you are? You know where you come from? You know where you're going? You got to know who you are. Know where you come from and know where you're going.
That's right.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God.
I'm just throwing this out here because God says, tell the people, be strong. Have
courage.
Eve convinced herself
that
God's word was for honorable. Eve convinced herself that God's word for her was too restrictive. It's too restrictive. It was holding. Me back from stuff I wanted to do.
Wow.
And God's word is restrictive.
Yeah.
You can't do a whole lot of things that you used to do, or you can't go where you used to go unless you're going to witness. And
Hallelujah.
Yeah, I know you some of you said, it's too restrictive, you know. That's important.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll say it again. Eve convinced herself that God's word was too restrictive for her. He really didn't mean that way. That's how the devil convinced you to go ahead and do what God says not do.
That's right.
The devil's very tricky. Wiles are to lure you by a magic spell. Music, you know. Crystal, smoke, incense, and
sage.
Stuff that burns your eyes and stuff like that. Blow up in your nose and stuff. See, the wiles is something that captivate.
Yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. Some of the music will captivate you and make you start to believe in what they're saying. Which is not of God.
Amen.
That's a wile. A wile is to charm. Yeah. That guy gonna try to charm you. Charm your clothes right off you. And say he love you, amen. Then he leave you for Susie. And Jane and Sally. But he loved you, praise God. He said he's going to give me the moon and the stars. Amen. He's charming you. Amen. And he's slinging his Jerry curl. Amen. That's a while. Oh, no. He got this new Mercedes, amen.
It's stolen, but you don't know that. Stolen, but you going for a ride in my stadium. Be strong. Have courage. Don't be bought by machinery.
Amen.
Don't be bought by some daffodils.
Amen.
Don't be tricked by a Snickers bar.
That's right. Oh,
that's right.
He said Reese's cup, but you know. They ain't got smaller and smaller now. They just have see, that's a cheap ride. That's a certain thing. I mean, come on. But be strong. Have courage. Don't sell yourself cheap. You're not a cheap thrill. Praise God. That's why he bring that pretty girl back there up. She made me pay.
That's a good thing.
Yeah, she made me pay for the Sammy experience.
You still paying?
Come on! You ain't getting nowhere.
You gonna pay for it?
This don't come cheap, she said.
That's right.
There ain't no bargain up here.
That's right.
And I had to pay full price.
Glory. Well, Beyonce, I put a ring on it.
Yeah.
That's right.
I'm still paying.
That's right.
It's worth it though, praise God.
That's right.
It's worth it. She's worth it, y'all.
That's right.
I got a virtuous Holy Ghost sanctified. Dancing, speaking in tongues. Woman God, praise God. Praise God. And I think I'm a keeper. I will be strong and very courageous. Praise God. And keep her at my side. And you do the same thing.
That's a wise decision.
Hey, my God. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I'm done. My God. But the Lord, he's amazing to us this morning. He's amazing to me because for the last four Sundays, he's been doing the same thing of bearing witness with his word through the altar presenter.
Amen.
The word that he wants to be spoken.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Especially this morning. He said, I want these people to know, I want them to be strong and have
courage.
No matter what you see coming down the pipe, be strong.
Be strong.
Have courage. For the Lord thy God is with you.
With us. Yes, he
He's
is.
For you.
For me.
Mm-hmm. Wherever thou goest. Mm-hmm. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. Yeah. As you stand to your feet in the presence of our holy God. Thank you for allowing me to have these few minutes before you. I pray for you right now. I pray.
Thank you, Lord.
That the Spirit of the living God will give you strength.
Yes, Lord.
To endure every wile of the devil, every trick, every scheme,
hallelujah,
every beguiling entity that tries to take you away from him who alone is worthy to be, and my God, to be praised. Say that, Hosea. Majesty, dominion and power belongs unto him.
Yes.
He has risen from the dead.
He has.
Hallelujah.
I want the ministers to come down. Praise God. Come on down. Ministers, come down. Okay. As these ministers come down, I want them to lay their hands upon every one of you and say, blessed. That's what they're going to do. They're going to lay hands and say, blessed. They're going to say, blessed. And you're going to just walk back to your seats. Amen. Praise God. They're going to say, blessed. Praise God. Usher in the back, lead them out. And they're going to touch you. Y'all get closer. Come on, y'all get closer together. Whoever stands before you, ministers, you lay your hands upon them and say, blessed. And you say, blessed in Jesus' name. When you lay hands, know you're going to bless them. No, you're releasing a blessing upon them. You say blessed.
Blessed.
And don't be cheap with your blessing. If you got something for them, give it to them. Just command them to be blessed. Bless. Bless in Jesus' name. Bless. In Jesus' name. Bless in Jesus' name. Hey, glory to God. Bless in Jesus' name. Praise God. Bless. I call you blessed. In Jesus' name. Bless in Jesus' name. Bless. Bless in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Lift your hands, please. I sense the Spirit of God in a mighty way in this room. As your hands are lifted to heaven, God sees your hands. Father, Shikoshana Mahaya. Father, in Jesus' name, I pray, Lord God, that these words that you have allowed me to speak will be spirit and life unto each one whose heart was lifted towards the hearing and the receiving of your word. I ask, Father, you confirm your word with signs following, that they may know, Lord God, that this word was not a word of a man, but a word of spirit and a word of truth. Thank you now, Lord. Let every life, Lord God, know of your holy presence. Oh God. Of your holy touch. Let increase, oh God. I pray the increase, Lord God, of the spirit of truth and revelation would be their portion now. In Jesus' name. And we thank you for it.
Thank you.
In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you for listening.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
Wanted to share for the last 3 weeks, just in alignment to what Apostle was speaking to us by the Holy Spirit today. We definitely have to take heed to that word, because something is about to come up on the face of this earth. My pastor was saying, terrorists, for the last 3 weeks, the Lord has been waking me up at 3:00 in the morning, and I just kept hearing destruction, destruction, intercede, pray. There's something coming up on this earth that we have never seen before. And there's a reason why the Lord was speaking through Apostle to be of good courage, to have faith, to stand in the last couple weeks unwavering. Those words are not for naught. Mm. So I just want to encourage all of us that we really need to go home and begin to just meditate on what God has given us today, mm-hmm. because as the Lord was telling me, destruction, destruction, I woke up and said, Lord, how do we prepare for destruction? What do? We can't stockpile food because food costs too much. So we can't stockpile. What do we do? And Apostle answered exactly what the Lord said. We have to be established, rooted, and grounded in his word. And the word has to be in our heart, and it cannot depart. And this is some serious times. And I just want to encourage us all to take this word seriously. When Apostle said terrorists, that clicked in my spirit, because the Lord kept saying destruction, but he's delaying it because he wants his people to get prepared and
Amen.
To be ready.
Amen.
And he said, but I know how to sustain those that put their trust and their hope in me. So when God gives us these words, it's not to plant fear in us, but it's to sustain us and to let us know that God know how to keep us.
Yes,
all hell is going to be breaking loose around us, but we are going to be sustained and kept by his power, because he had already warned us. Apostle, through the Lord, the Lord speaking mm-hmm. through Apostle, and warned us for the past 4 weeks now,
mm-hmm.
month now. And God has said it's because he's delaying so we can get ready. He's giving us time to get ready. So I just want to encourage us all to just continue to stand, to be strong, mm-hmm. and have courage. Those words, were not apostles. Those were definitely from the Lord.
Oh, with all my heart to my children here at Freedom, I was vacillating, reluctant to stand this morning, but early this morning, as last night and this morning, as I continued in his presence, and just, I wondered what I'm going to say this morning. You know, you can't just say anything.
No.
And so I just wait on the Lord. I wasn't going to say nothing if he would consider me. That's why I chose this young man of God to be ready. And just like she was always ready. But when she started reading Joshua 1, I said, this girl been reading my notes. She snuck in my office and looked at my notepad, reading my notes. And, but God's saying, you know what God's saying?
Mm-hmm.
He said, I'm with you.
I'm with you. That's right.
That's what he was saying. I'm with you.
I got you.
He's with you.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
He's with us.
Yes,
sir. Thank you, Lord.
They weren't no fancy words, and I, you know, sometimes I'm reluctant, okay? I didn't give enough or this and that. It don't matter.
No.
Right. Just say what he says.
That's it.
Do what he tells you to do.
Amen.
And then you sit down.
But
he says, be strong.
Yes.
And have courage. Because he's with us.
With us.
Are you listening this morning? Amen. I give God praise for this moment right here.
Amen.
And for his precious people that you are. Very precious and dear unto God.
Time of trouble to be prepared.
Amen.
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 Even as he told the children, I give you the land. He had already given it. All they had to do was take possession of what he had given.
Mm-hmm.
So he's already made provisions. He's the all-seeing, all-knowing, everywhere present God. And he says, it's coming, be prepared. That's the benefit. We know ahead of time. Amen. And he says he's with us. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. If you would like to pay your tithes and offering electronically, you can do so by using Givelify app and the Cash app. Amen.
Mm-hmm.
And for our social media viewers, you can also give via mail, P.O. Box 10368, Cleveland, Ohio, 44110. And depending on the weather, which God has been gracious to us.
Yes, Jesus. Yes.
I prayed for Indian summer, y'all.
Amen.
I said, Lord.
All year to the real summer.
Can we just have Indian summer
spring
this year?
Yeah. Amen.
And he's heard and he's answered.
Yes, he has.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. 50 and 60 degrees weather.
Woo!
Yes.
Nobody but Jesus.
Nobody.
But Bible study Wednesday at 7 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
There will be prayer on Saturday at 9 a.m. via teleconferencing.
Both.
The teleconference call is 605-313-5826. It's on the screen, but I'll read it to you. The access code is 851-2827 pound. Order number sign. Amen. And we'll be here at Freedom at 9 o'clock.
Oh, yes.
And intercessory begin at 9:30. Amen. God be here, so come see Jesus. Amen. There will be two mandatory ushers meeting this month. First meeting will be Sunday, February 25th, immediately after service, and the other will be held Sunday, March 24th, also immediately after service. If you have any question, please see Elder Field, Elder Philip Lee. Amen. Sight and Sound Theater presents Daniel. Friends and family travel invite you to come and see this beautiful production on October 11th through the 12th. Deposit is $100 and it's due by May 17th. Additional information is on the flyer on the back table. Your contribution statements are ready. You can pick them up in the trust in the secretary's office. Secretary's office. Amen. Amen.
Amen. I'd just like to thank everyone that gave toward the door. It's installed.
Amen. Amen.
I'd like to thank Minister Elmo and Elder Harry for coming and being with them for 2 weeks trying to get it in properly. So, but it's in now and the locks are working. So if you would like to use that side door, you can.
Amen. 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 See?
And it's totally paid for.
Amen.
Amen. That's what family do.
That's what family do.
Yes.
Amen. Once God return unto you for being obedient.
Amen.
Yes, that's a benefit.
Benefit. Forget not your benefits.
That's right.
Psalms 103, girl. Yes, it is. Ushers, come down. Everybody stand. You got your offering envelopes ready? Amen. Man can't outdo God with benefits.
You better come on.
Sometimes they don't want to honor your benefits. God said it.
God, yeah, you honor.
God make it right.